Hurricane Florence might not have been really a hurricane, considered to be a tropical storm, but that didn't mean it didn't cause any damage. The Carolinas saw unending rain, forcing residents to leave their homes and all their belongings behind as they fled from historic flooding. Families were desperate, knowing that all they worked for would be destroyed, but what was more heartbreaking was that animals were lost or even abandoned. Whether they were farm animals, pets in the backyard, or at a shelter, many of them had no way of transportation to safety. For example, volunteers heard howls from afar. As they approached a backyard, six dogs were swimming in their locked cage. When a man heard howling far away, he stopped what he was doing and went to investigate. As he approached a backyard, he couldn't believe his eyes. A locked cage filled with water was holding six dogs who kept jumping on the fence, happy to finally see a human pass by. Rising waters would have been a death sentence for them. The very first thing you do when disaster is on its way is to take your loved ones to safety. It doesn't matter if it's the family hamster, cat, dog, or raccoon, and so on. You take them with you and the rest of the family, just like these people did. At the end of the day, you know you've done a humane act. That's what the rescuers thought when they saw the caged dogs. Two volunteers responded to the disaster and lent a hand to those in need. They also stopped to save the dogs from the flooded crate, and they didn't do it for praise or attention. They did it to raise awareness and remind people to do the right thing, just like this man, who bought a bus to save animals from drowning. As they patrolled through Leland, North Carolina, they heard the dogs howling. Wait and see what happens after. Ryan Nichols and David Rebeler were in Leland, helping people gather some of their belongings and go to safety. They were accompanied by journalist Marcus DiPaolo when they heard the dogs howling. They went to investigate the noise and saw a cage behind a house almost half filled with water. Nicholas said in an interview, "The dogs were almost underwater. One of them filmed the moment as the other unlocked the cage. Within an hour, they would have been dead," said Nicholas. He saw the dogs barking, pawing at the cage, trying to stay above the water. The footage was posted on Twitter, shocking thousands of people. He wrote, "Rescued six dogs in Leland, North Carolina, after the owner left them, locked in an outdoor cage filled with water that was rapidly rising." What did they do after releasing them? Here's where the story gets emotional. The traumatized animals swam out of their cages, whimpering, howling, and sniffing around the backyard, making sure things were all right. But that's not all that happened. Meanwhile, DiPaolo shot and tweeted the moments, and in just a day or two, the video gathered more than 3 million views. People were outraged, and the media outlets started covering the story. According to the neighbors, the family that owned the dogs left panicked sometime between Saturday night and Sunday morning, a few hours before the volunteers heard the howls. The neighbors said that among the dogs was an 8-month-old puppy. Here's what Nichols said about this heartbreaking event. Nichols is from Houston, and last year his home and business were flooded during Hurricane Harvey. But in those moments, he and a Rebeler helped people get to safety. "That's when I decided, when we see a hurricane, we're going to help." They helped over 30 people in one day and didn't stop until they made sure that the dogs were all right too. As for DiPaolo, he was shocked to see the caged dogs. The rest of the backyard was on higher ground, and the pups were happy to touch the ground again. The rescuers found some dog food and fed the six pooches who were wagging their tails in excitement. Free again and safe from the floods, they took back their yard and checked every single corner, probably looking for their family. Then they got outside the yard. Usually, the first responders in these situations are the ones that come across lost animals like dogs, cats, donkeys, or horses, all desperate to escape the flood. But this case was worse because caged or chained animals have no chance of survival. If people cannot take their animals with them, at least let them have the freedom to flee hazards, commented outraged people when hearing this story. DiPaolo wrote on Twitter, "We got them out, but by the time we left, the water was so high that they would have drowned, adding the urgent request, bring your pets with you. Unfortunately, this case is not the only one during such unfortunate events, and Tony Alsup, another animal savior, was ready to go help the ones left behind. Realizing their family was not home, dogs got out of the yard as if checking for some scents left by their owners as they left in a hurry. The dogs took off towards a nearby wooded area, and the rescuers followed them closely. We can't save them all, but we at least have to give these animals their better chances. And that's why this story was covered by many news outlets, urging people to have some compassion and not leave their animals behind. They recommended owners to ask for help and do their best to take their pets with them. Even if saved, these animals end up in shelters. We hope that the caged dogs now have a better chance at survival and were taken to safety. So far, there isn't any update on their welfare. However, there are many cases like this one.